How to activate Cricket Wireless eSIM. Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, we're gonna learn how we can activate the Cricket Wireless eSIM. So without any further delay, let's begin with the video. But before beginning, I want you to make sure to hit that like, share, and subscribe icon. So in order to set up the Cricket Wireless eSIM on your device, there are certain process that you need to go with. So in order to do that, first of all, you need to log in into a Cricket Wireless application onto your device. After that, log in or create an account into your device. After that, what I want you to do is head over to the main settings of your device. For that, just close this. So let me just close this and head over to the main settings. After that, go under connections, and here you should be able to see this SIM card manager section. So what you can do is simply tap on this. After tapping on it here, you should be able to see a eSIM section if your phone is something that is compatible with eSIM. So in order to activate the Cricket Wireless eSIM, your phone should have the support settings or system of having an eSIM to have an eSIM. So since my device is not compatible with that settings, which I'm just going to tell you process on how you can do it. After that, when you come to the settings and come under SIM card manager, you should be able to see a eSIM section here. So what you're going to do is simply tap on that eSIM. After that, on the device there, you should be able to see a QR code scanner. So what you're going to do is simply open up the Cricket Wireless application in another device. And from that device, you need to log in into your account or create an account in that Cricket Wireless account. So what you're going to do is there you will be able to see a QR code. So what you will do next is simply scan the QR code from the device from here, SIM card manager, from the eSIM section. So just scan the code and the eSIM should be added on your device. And that's it. So therefore, just follow those steps and you should be able to add or set up the eSIM on your device. So I hope this video was helpful to you, and thank you for watching this video.